In this video, we are going to take a look at this indicator here. It's a shifted moving average, which means that we use one moving average and project the results into the future. So let's see how we can do something like this with MQL5.
In this MQL5 code, a string variable named signal is created to store the trading signal. This signal will be either buy or sell. Two arrays, my moving average array and my shifted average array, are declared. These arrays will store values of moving averages. Two moving averages are defined using the IAMF function. Moving average definition calculates a 50-period simple moving average using the closing prices of the current symbol and period. Shifted average definition calculates another 50-period SMA, but with a 20-period shift applied. The array set as series function is used to sort the my moving average array and my shifted average array in descending order. The copy buffer function is used to copy the last three values of both moving averages into their respective arrays. The values of the current candle for both moving averages are calculated and stored in my moving average value and my shifted average value. Trading signals are generated based on the comparison of these moving average values. If my moving average value is greater than my shifted average value, it sets signal to buy. If my moving average value is less than my shifted average value, it sets signal to sell. The current trading signal, buy or sell, is displayed on the chart using the comment function. This code calculates two moving averages, compares their values, and generates a buy or sell signal based on the comparison. It then displays the current trading signal on the trading chart for reference.
Okay, by now you should have a working version of this indicator on your chart. I hope everything went well. If it was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code does, you maybe want to watch one of the other videos, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, I say thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.